Today's story is a story from Alfie and Annie Rose. My class really enjoyed these stories, so there's lots of stories in this book, and one of them's called Mr. McNally's Hat. One morning, Mum took Alfie across the street to Mrs. McNally's house to be looked after by Mrs. McNally, while she and Annie Rose went to see the doctor. Mrs. McNally was a very busy person. She did a lot of dusting and polishing and vacuuming, and she cleaned her windows until they sparkled and shone. That morning, Mrs. McNally was having what she called a good clear out. So she and Alfie went upstairs, and Alfie pushed his toy cars about on the bedroom floor, while Mrs. McNally pulled everything out of the big cupboard. She folded the shirts and trousers carefully and put them on the bed. Then she started to sort out the rest of the things. Alfie stopped playing and helped her put the clothes into different piles. When they found a pair of Mr. McNally's socks or gloves, they put them together. When they found an odd sock or glove, they put them into another pile until they found a pair for it. Soon, the whole floor, as well as the bed, was covered with the neat piles of matching clothes. At last, from the very back of the cupboard, Mrs. McNally brought out a large black hat. "Goodness, there's that awful hat," she said, dusting it off with her sleeve and holding it up to the light. The hat looked quite new. Mrs. McNally told Alfie that Mr. McNally had bought it to wear at a very special occasion and that he had paid a lot of money for it. "He thought it would give him height," Mrs. McNally said, but she didn't think that hat suited Mr. McNally at all well. So it had hung unworn on the peg in the hall for a long time, until in the end she had taken it down and put it at the very back of the cupboard, where she hoped that Mr. McNally would forget all about it. And he had. Alfie thought that Mr. McNally's hat was a very good hat indeed. He tried it on in front of the big mirror. At first he couldn't see anything at all, but when he pushed it up a bit, he could see out. While Mrs. McNally put all the clothes tidily back into the cupboard, Alfie walked up and down in the hat. When Mum came to collect him, Mrs. McNally said he had been such a good, helpful little boy all morning, and that if he liked, he could take the hat home with him and keep it. Alfie thanked Mrs. McNally and put all his cards into the hat to carry them back across the street. Alfie liked Mr. McNally's hat so much that he wore it for the rest of the day. It had some dents in it, but he punched them out so that the top was all smooth and rounded. At bedtime, he put the hat carefully at the bottom of his bed. The next morning, he wore the hat to nursery school. Mrs. Palmer, his teacher, said that it was such a beautiful hat that it would be safer if Alfie hung it up with the coats while they were indoors. But when it was time to go outside in the yard, where the climbing frame and the slide and all the trucks and trolleys were, Alfie put on the hat again. All the other children crowded round Alfie, and Alfie let them take turns at trying it on. Then they invented a very good game in which the person who was wearing the hat ran about chasing all the other people, and if someone got caught, then it was their turn to wear the hat. For the next few days, Alfie wore the hat a lot. When he got tired of wearing it, he put it at the bottom of the toy cupboard where he kept his special things. Annie Rose found it there and made it into a bed for her lamb, but soon they both forgot about the hat altogether. One of Alfie's very good friends was the milkman. Alfie liked to watch out for him coming up the street in his milk float. When he came whistling up the steps to leave the milk on the doorstep of Alfie's house, Alfie would wave from the window and the milkman always waved back. And when Mum and Alfie met him out delivering the milk around the neighbourhood, he would call out, "Watch you, mate, how's yourself?" And Alfie would call back, "Fine, thanks, mate." Then the milkman would give him a thumbs up. "Okay, son," as he drove on. In cold weather, the milkman sometimes wore a woolly hat, but the rest of the time he didn't wear anything on his head at all. One wet morning when the rain was pouring down, Alfie looked out of the window and saw the milkman running up the steps of their house with all his hair soaking and plastered down his forehead. The raindrops were dripping down his nose and off the end of his beard. Alfie had a very kind thought. While Mum was paying the milkman, Alfie went to the toy cupboard and brought out Mr. McNally's black hat. Then he ran to the door. "Here's a present for you," he said, holding it out. "It's to keep your head dry." "Thanks a lot," said the milkman, looking at the hat. "That's a good hat, that is." Then he clapped it over his head, went off down the steps and drove off. But the next time Alfie saw the milkman, he wasn't wearing the hat, nor the time after that. "Doesn't he like the hat that I gave him?" Alfie asked his mum anxiously. But Mum said, "Oh, I'm sure he likes it a lot. It's just that the weather's been fine and I expect he's keeping it for a rainy day." The next time it rained, Alfie was at the window waiting for the milkman to come up the street. But when at last the milk float stopped outside Alfie's house and the milkman came up the steps, he still wasn't wearing the hat. Then Alfie was so upset that he burst into tears. And when the milkman saw his sad face at the window, he rang the doorbell even though it wasn't payday. Mum and Alfie hurried to the door. "What's up, mate?" the milkman asked Alfie. "You aren't wearing the hat I gave you," sobbed Alfie. Then the milkman said, "Come along with me and you'll see why not." Then Mum helped Alfie put on his mac and his boots and rain hat, and he and the milkman went out into the street to where the milk float was. Then the milkman hoisted Alfie up and plumped him down next to the driver's seat. There, on the seat, was the hat. Alfie looked inside and guess what he saw? A little puppy, curled up fast asleep with his paws over his nose. He had floppy black ears and a black tail. "He's a stray," the milkman said, told Alfie. "A lady up the street found him on a doorstep all wet and shivering, so I took him along with me." Alfie touched the puppy's back very gently. It felt firm and warm. "He just got into the hat and settled down, as though he'd slept in it all his life," said the milkman. "Me and the wife have been thinking about getting a dog, so if nobody claims him, I'll keep him." Just then the puppy opened his eyes and licked Alfie's hand. And at that moment, Alfie couldn't think of a better use for Mr. McNally's hat. Thank you for watching. See you tomorrow.